Now, it's one of the most successful stage musicals in the world, and this weekend, The Lion King celebrates its 15th year of entertaining audiences in London. To mark the occasion, the producers have decided to give away 1,500 free tickets for the anniversary performance. Our entertainment correspondent, Brenda Emmanus, has more.
It has entertained over 12 million theatre-goers and remains one of the West End's best-selling stage productions. Not even a cold, wet Monday morning could deter fans of The Lion King from seizing the opportunity of free tickets to their 15th anniversary performance this weekend.
My six-year-old granddaughter had a terrible car accident a few weeks ago, and I'd love to bring her to this.
Have you seen the production yourself?
I saw it on the second night 15 years ago.
The Lion King's an old film, so the fact that they can connect with adults as well who remember it from their childhood, I think is really good.
I want to go on a date and I want to find a girl, and I think it'll be awesome if I say I've got 2 tickets to The Lion King.
Now, Sunday's your actual 15th anniversary. Whose decision was it to have this amazing free offer for all the fans?
So we talked to our boss, Tom Schumacher, who produced the show right from the word go, and he thought it would be a great idea to really thank the people of London and our audience for supporting the show over the last 15 years.
The worldwide box office success of the show is unprecedented, and next year your kids may be demanding Simba and Nala costumes as Disney release licensed school versions of the musical.
Such a huge production. Can you give us any idea of how many people would work on costumes and masks alone?
Yeah, so we have a team of about half a dozen people in the puppet and mask department. The wardrobe department is a team of about 20. In total, if you include the cast and the musicians and all the crew, there are 150 people night to night working on the show.
So, 15 triumphant years for the West End cast of this great African tale, and one happy Sunday in store for determined fans. Brenda Emmanus, BBC London News.